In a fundraising pitch of just a few days ago, Republicans started to sound the alarm bells about how pathetic their fundraising has been so far in this election cycle. The message that they posted on social media, which was also sent out in an email, I believe, says, "Here's the honest truth. Things aren't looking too good for Republicans. The Democrats are outraising us. They will be able to buy ads in markets we can't afford, and they will outspend us. We are gearing up for the election of our lifetime." Now, typically, campaign fundraising emails do use scare tactics, right? Whenever these people, whether it's through text messages, phone calls, emails, or posts on social media, they always make it sound like, oh God, we're in dire financial straits. You got to give us money, right? So that's not out of the ordinary, except for the fact that this one time, the Republicans are actually telling the truth. I know it's shocking, right? Republicans telling us the truth, but that is what's happening here. Because the Republican Party right now has $8.7 million cash on hand. I'm not talking about a candidate has $8.7 cash on hand. I'm talking about the Republican Party of the United States has $8.7 million in a presidential election year. In a year where they're not only trying to retake the White House, but retake the Senate and maintain control of the House of Representatives, they got less than $9 million. That is pathetic. Now, Avi, if I had $9 million, you'd never hear from me again. But for a national political party to only have $9 million, that's a bad thing. Especially when the Biden campaign raised $42 million in January alone. You guys are getting clobbered. So this pitch from the Republican Party, like, oh no, the Democrats are beating us, that's not just them trying to get people to donate. That is them legitimately freaking out because they don't have the money. Donald Trump doesn't have the money to run his campaign. Add to that the fact that you have the chair of the Republican Party itself, Ronna McDaniel. She's resigning in an election year. That's not something that typically happens. So you have no leadership at the party. When you do eventually get new leadership during an election year, it's going to be somebody that does not have the experience of running a national party. They don't get a honeymoon period where they can try to figure things out for a couple months and, okay, we don't have any elections to worry about, so let me get my footing here. No, they're going to take over the Republican Party at a time when it's damn near bankrupt in the middle of a massive election year. That is setting up whoever it is for failure. And it's probably going to be Michael Whatley, the chair of the South Carolina Republican Party, along with Donald Trump's daughter-in-law, Laura Trump. So on top of not having time to get their footing underneath them, you're also going to be putting somebody in there who, one, has no experience running a political party in Laura Trump, and two, already promised to give all the party's money to Donald Trump. So, yikes, right? I mean, if I were a Republican donor, I wouldn't give them any money knowing that that's what's going to happen to it. And that's why they're so freaked out today. They know that they don't have enough cash on hand, and they know that the turmoil inside their party in an election year is about to turn off nearly every major donor that they have left. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.